Hey everybody, so I'm back to film a drugstore haul video. It's been forever since I've done a haul, I think. I'm pretty sure it's been forever. I just typically just do a bunch of reviews lately, but I felt like just doing a haul because there's so many new drugstore products out. I've been reviewing some of the newer ones, like the Physician's Formula BB Cream, like that review, and that whole line review is already up. The next review I'll be doing is on the Revlon Naked Foundation and Powder. I'm still testing it out right now. I bought another shade, which I'm wearing in this video with its powder, etc., etc. So yeah, that will be the next review. But I was out drugstore hunting because I needed to go buy the lighter shade in the Revlon Foundation. And I had like CVS Extra Care Bucks to use in such and such. So I wanted to pick up a couple things I saw at CVS the other day. Today, a lot of the stuff I'm showing you guys in this video I'm wearing on my face right now because I wanted to test it out right away because I'm just impatient like that. So I can give you guys a little bit of a first impressions in a sense. I'm going to start with the new L'Oreal True Match Concealer. Little concealer sticks that L'Oreal just came out with. Their True Match line has been around for a very long time. There is a foundation which looks like this. And I'm in shade W4. I feel like in the wintertime it would be more like W3, but I haven't worn it in a while, so that is what it is. They also have a True Match Lumi foundation, which I'm not that much of a fan of. I like the regular True Match more, and I also have the True Match powder, so I think I own the whole True Match line right now. This is what the True Match powder looks like. And when I'm usually between NC30, NC35, W4 is okay. I feel like W3 would be a little light, but it would also work pretty well for me. It's actually not with the other True Match products yet because it's new. It's on a new display. Most stores I've seen, it has like a big L'Oreal display. And then it's in like a little cylinder thing on the side. And in the middle has like eyeshadows that just came out, mascara, and the new lip stains, which I've already done a review on if you haven't seen that. I'll link it down below. But yeah, it's in like a cylinder thing, and then they're all like slid in like this, and then you just grab the ones in the correct slot. So this was in the wrong slot, and I didn't double check, which is my fault. I was planning on getting W4 and W5 because the concealer shades are actually in ranges. So since I'm a W4, I would get the W4, W5 for like blemishes and such, whatever's on my face I need to cover. And then I wanted to get a lighter one for any under eye highlighting or face highlighting I needed. So I wanted to get like the W3. Which they have a W1 through 3 range, so one stick is like W1 through 3, which is I think a little weird. I'd rather have them do one for W1, one for W2, one for W3, like individual for each shade instead of doing ranges, because doing a 3-in-1 type of concealer stick, someone's gonna end up with the wrong shade, if you know what I'm saying. 4 and 5 together in one stick, I get it could work, but I think it'd be better individually, personally. I accidentally picked up the N1, 2, and 3 instead of the W, which is the neutral one. They do not have any of the cool tone ones, so there's no C's. I actually looked up on the L'Oreal site. It only comes in 6 shades, and they're either N or W. So they have the N1, 2, 3 in one stick, the W1, 2, 3 in one stick, the 4 and 5, the 4 and 5, and then I think they have a 6 and 7 for each, so there's no cool tones. I don't know if I'm going to exchange this for the W1, because this is just like... just off. I'm wearing it under my eyes right now. It's a little bright, but like it does blend, so it was a little forgiving. The cool thing about these pens or crayons is that they do retract, you know, you can twist them out in. So they're twisties. They have the exact same packaging as the Revlon Just Bitten Lip Balm Stain Pencils that look just like this. And Neutrogena just came out with some that look just like this too. I think my only pet peeve about pencils like this is that the hygienic factor, you know, you could always, I guess, apply it onto the back of your hand instead of applying it directly on your face. And I don't like the fact that you can't twist it all the way down. Like, it has to stick up, like, just a little bit. Because clumsy people like myself could also, you know, knock off the top of the concealer if they're not careful. But it's not that big of a deal. Obviously, I'd rather have it be able to twist up and down than have to sharpen it or something like that. And for some reason, the W4, W5 blended a lot easier. It was a lot more creamy on application, and it blended better. I don't know if it's just maybe the end pencil is just a little off, but all in all, if I'm going off of the one that's the correct shade, it blended well, it covered well, it could be a full coverage, basically a full coverage concealer, medium to full coverage right away. It is a thicker concealer, and it doesn't seem to be doing anything funky over fine lines or blemishes, and it doesn't seem to be like falling into my pores, so all in all, no complaints. I'm not wearing any primer right now, so really, if it wanted to fall into these pores, it could. but no complaints. Then I picked up two Physician Formula blushes. These are not new. These are the only non-new products shown in this video. So don't go crazy that they're not new. I picked up the Physician Formula Happy Booster Blush in Warm. And the concept between this is that it's supposed to make you happy. But no one really expects that from their blush. I picked this up a long time ago, but in the natural shade, which was okay, but I didn't really love it. So I gave it to my sister-in-law, who did love it, and she used it every day till she basically hit pan on it. And I picked up the warm shade because it seemed a little bit more peachy. Doesn't it look peachy in the pan? And because Physician's Formula is having a deal right now at CVS, and the couponer in me just had to, you know, pick up things that I was kind of curious about. Basically, I will break it down for you guys really quick. Physician's Formula, there's certain things that are 50% off. They have that the whole 50% off sticker thing. You know, when they sticker certain shades and certain products at CVS right now. But this does not count for those. Those are already clearance items, so what I'm about to say has nothing to do with those. These were regular price. Regular price, $13, I think 29 cents each. So let's just say $13. For this week, everything that is regular price, CVS is taking $5 off. There's like little labels over the products that say $5 off instantly at checkout. So these already dropped to $8 each, which is already a good deal. But then certain Physician's Formula products have $3 off stickers, which you could use on any of the products in line. So if you just want to rip it off the packaging, you could, and use it right at checkout. So it makes everything $5 each. So I got both these for $5 each for $5.29. So 10 bucks, which is less than the price of one. So I figured I would just get it since I was curious about both of these blushes. Just had to do. My sister's a couponer. I'm partially a couponer. I just haven't had time to coupon like crazy. So when I find good deals, I just try to, you know, get the best. As for the warm shade, I don't really love it. I just swatched it. I didn't wear it today. And off swatching, it is not as light as I thought it would be. It's actually pretty dark when all swirled together. I'm sure if I'd focused on like the lightish part of the blush, it'd be lighter. Yeah, it's lighter. But when you swirl together, it looks kind of like that, which is darker than what I wanted. So maybe I'll just end up giving it to my sister-in-law. I'll try it on a different day. But I am wearing the other Physician's Formula blush right now on my cheeks. And this is their Mineral Wear Talc-Free Blush in Rosy Glow, which is a blush that's been around for a very long time. I'm pretty sure it's like permanent in their line. And I've been looking for like the Natural Glow one for a long time, but I only saw Rosy Glow. But I figured it looked pretty good and got good reviews online, so I do really love this blush. It's very pigmented. It has a little bit of fallout, as you can see, but I'm just going to pat the fallout into my hand right now, and look, no problem whatsoever. Blends amazingly, very pigmented. It is talc-free, so if you are in any way allergic to talc, you'll love it. And I am, like I said, wearing it right now. It does like a nice pinky flush that's not too much, and you can blend out or build it up. All in all, a really good blush and a really good everyday blush. After those two products, everything else I picked up at Walgreens. And I went to Walgreens looking for the new Wet n Wild Color Icon Foundation that I heard about online. Can't find it yet. None of my Walgreens seem to have it. So I will have to wait and see how that goes. I'm a big fan of Wet n Wild, the brand generally. It's one of my favorite drugstore brands. It has great prices. And their Color Icon lines, their eyeshadows, their lipsticks, their nail polishes, and blushes are just amazing for the price. The pigmentation is really good. So when Wet n Wild gets new things, I tend to scoop it. They have a new Fergie collection. So basically, they partnered with Fergie, you know. They partnered with Fergie a long time ago, and they released nail polish, but now they released cosmetics. They have lipsticks. I picked 4 lipsticks up. They have eyeshadow palettes. I only picked one of those up. They also have a cream liner. And it's actually in a better packaging than their typical liner, which is in like plastic packaging. It's in the same packaging as the L'Oreal and Maybelline liners. And then they have, I guess, these, they look like giant size blushes, to be honest. I don't really know. It's supposed to be a Center Stage collection, Two Reflect Shimmer Palette. This one is in Rose Golden Goddess, and it's supposed to reflect the rock star within and make your face glow. It's a just huge blush. It's ginormous, like blush or bronzer. I don't know, just cheek product generally. But these were the only cheek products they had. So I picked up one. They only had 2 different shades at the store I was at. I'm sure there's 4 shades because there was 4 little sections, but I picked up the rose gold one because rose gold always sounds tempting. Oh, and they also have a primer, which I took out of the packaging already. I took the packaging off of the eyeliner and the primer because I'm wearing them right now. But I do have shots of both of them when they're still in their packaging. And I figured, why not try out the primer? It's actually a funny name because it's called For My Primas, like prime with AS, you know what I'm saying? It's the Take on the Day eyeshadow primer, so it's supposed to keep your eye shadow looking fresh and such. And it's supposed to have the same consistency as like the Too Faced Shadow Insurance and the Urban Decay Primer Potion. And let me just tell you guys the prices of things. The eyeshadow palette, the shadow primer, and the eyeliner were all $5, $4.99 each. And then the blush was $5.99 each because it's so ginormous it had to be an extra dollar. And all the lipsticks were $3.49 each, so roughly $3.50 each, which isn't bad. And certain Wet n Wild lipsticks have like a dollar off coupon on them, so you can use like the dollar off right away. So it'll make it like $2.50 each, which is really cheap. So I'm going to start by just telling you guys about the eyeliner. The eyeliner, I was hoping that it was the same formula as their typical color Icon eyeliner that comes in the crappy plastic packaging that causes the eyeliner to dry out, because I love that eyeliner to death. If you've been watching me for years, you know that that was my favorite drugstore liner for a very long time. The only problem I had with it is that it would dry out over time because of the packaging being so poor. It's just causing the liner to dry out really fast in the pan, which I would always have to buy a new one every like 2 or 3 months without even hitting pan on the eyeliner. It just ended up drying out. So after a while, I just ventured onto other liners. I've been using the L'Oreal Infallible Gel Liner, and that has been working really, really well. Not really a fan of the Maybelline one, but yeah, back to the Wet n Wild Fergie edition. It is not the same formula whatsoever, at least for my first impression, because I am wearing it right now on my top and lower lash line. It is nice and black. It's dark. It applies creamy, very smooth. The problem I'm having with this is that it tends to budge. And that's a problem with eyeliner. Like, obviously it's not bleeding down my face right now, which is great. That, I appreciate eyeliner. But I always rock a wing eyeliner. And then when I do my wing eyeliner, let's pretend this is an angled eyeliner brush. I use the angled eyeliner brush and I start to flick outward from my eye, like in small motions to create the wing, and then I draw it back. That's how I always do my wing eyeliner. It's not that difficult for an eyeliner typically to just stay where you want it to be. This eyeliner, you can see that as I go over certain spots, the eyeliner is moving. Like, you can see it's starting to create little lines in a way. Like, how am I supposed to say this? It basically starts to move itself. Like, you can see like little patches in the eyeliner, which bothers me because then you have to go over and kind of dab on top of it and not go like this, because otherwise it's gonna move it and you're gonna see like a bare spot in the middle of your line. I had to tap over it to make it like a complete solid. It's like a two-layer eyeliner, otherwise you'll have little patches and splotches. It's not completely opaque, which is a problem because the regular color Icon gel liner doesn't do that. It dries really fast as you're using it, thus why I loved it. And it's really pigmented and really affordable. It was like $3, like $2.99, and it's just not the same. Of course they probably had to bump up the price because the packaging is different, but they could have kept the formula the same. That's what I'm saying, Wet n Wild, what's the issue? As for the eyeshadow primer, when I first used it, I was very shocked because a bunch of oil came out of the tube. Like, no primer, just oil dripping down the back of my hand, like a lot of it, like cooking oil almost. Pretty much I think the product settled in the tube because it was just hung up on the display for a long time. And I didn't know you really had to shake stuff like this. There's no like rolly ball thing inside. It's not like a nail polish. I don't typically shake my eyeshadow primers, but you need to shake it before you use it. And then it's kind of like ketchup. When you first use ketchup, you know, some of that water comes out. It's basically doing the same thing. And then the primer comes out. But the primer comes out with a lot of oil too. It's like really liquidy and oily, which bothers me. It's not like just solid. I don't know if it's just because of the packaging or I don't know the formula, but it blends to like a pinky transparent appearance. It feels just like the Urban Decay and Too Faced, just a little bit greasier because of that oil. And I currently have no problems with it. My eyeshadows are not creasing. They did apply a little bit more pigmented as they should with a primer, and you could feel it adhere to the slight tacky texture of the primer. It's just slightly tacky, nothing too crazy. You could see and feel your eyeshadow as you're putting it on, like, stick to where you want it to be. So I appreciated that. It's like a typical primer. The oily and greasiness of it, I was not loving. As for the eyeshadow palette, I am wearing some of the eyeshadows right now. It comes with your typical sponge tip applicator that's kind of curved, which isn't usually that typical. This is actually the palette in Metropolitan Nights, and it comes with two blacks, a gold yellow color, a white, and like a taupey silver color. They also have a purple eyeshadow palette, a matte, really bright eyeshadow palette. It's like greens, blues, and purples. And then, I don't know, I didn't really pay attention to the last one. I think there's four. All in all, it's pretty good. I'm wearing them right now. I'm wearing the black shade that's right here on my outer corner. I'm wearing the gray shade on my lid and the yellow shade right here on my inner corner. So those three. I don't know why they added two blacks in this palette. It makes no sense to me because the black on the outer circle is supposed to have like gold shimmers. Everything's supposed to be shimmery except for the center color in this palette, but the gold flecks in the black on the outer circle do not show when you apply, so it's the same thing as the one in the middle, which I don't get. It pretty much shows up exactly the same to the same intensity and everything, so it's just a waste of space. As for the quality, it's the same as most Wet n Wild eyeshadows. There's just a lot of fallout. My eyeshadow palette is really dirty, and I only used it once. I used it today. The black got everywhere, and the really, really, really pretty taupey color is not as pigmented as the black. It's pigmented enough to use, not as pigmented, sadly. I did not use the white, but it's just like your typical pearly white. I wouldn't like that as a highlight because it is kind of shimmery and I'm a matte highlight type of girl. And the gold color was actually kind of chalky. It was harder to use. I needed to apply it wet to get it to show on my inner corner. Otherwise, it was just like really glittery and flecky. So that shadow was probably the poorest quality out of the quad, but the blacks were really good. I mean, typical Wet n Wild quality. So I would probably stick to the Typical Color Icon eyeshadow palettes instead of the Fergie ones, just because I like the quality more. As for this jumbo blush, or shimmer palette as they call it, I don't know why they would call it a palette. There's only one thing in it, so there's no reason to call it a palette. It is shimmery, like I'm saying, so I would not use this as a concealer. This is very shimmery and very terracotta-y, not so much rose gold in my opinion, a little bit darker than rose gold, so I wouldn't really wear this on my cheeks. Let's put a little bit. Am I glowing now? No, not really. I feel like it was a little too strong for this look. It would make me really orangey, so I didn't want to wear it on my cheeks. This maybe would be more appropriate for summertime. It's very orange and very shimmery. Saving the best for last, the lipsticks. Amazing. Love them. The packaging is so chic, so pretty. As you can see, it just is a nice silver tube. It's a lot taller than the typical Wet n Wild Color Icon ones. It has like a little Fergie emblem right here. Same concept. The lipstick peeks out from the top. Twistable labels on the bottom. Thank God they put labels on the bottom. And they actually put the names on the bottom for once, because these only have the number and the name comes off of the little like safety seal. When you take it off, you throw it away, so you have to kind of remember the name. But these have the names on the bottom. Thank you, Wet n Wild, for that. I picked up four shades. There are some shimmery shades in the Fergie line, like maybe like two, no more than three. But the rest of them are creamy shades. By creamy, I mean like creamy mattes, not matte the finish, but no shimmer. I'm wearing the lightest shade, which is Fergie Daily right now, which is number 33. Pretty. It was a little too pink right away just because of the shirt I'm wearing. It almost matched too perfectly, so I warmed it up a little bit with my favorite Revlon Sunset Peach lip gloss, and it's a lot better now. It's not as like pinky nude, because with this shirt it was too much. It was crazy. That is what Fergie Daily looks like. Very nice, very pigmented. Then I picked up number 34, which is Bebop Love, and it's pretty much named after the Black Eyed Peas song. It's Filipino and Tagalog. I know, I'm not Filipino, by the way. And I figure between the Fergie Daily and this lipstick that one is going to be super flattering on me and the other one probably won't, because they're kind of close, but not really. So let's take off Fergie Daily. Oh, I do like this one. This one is more my type of nude, like a really wearable, almost brownie, neutral nude. I like it. It's more, works with everything, not as Palin. Number 39, Fuchsianista, and it's a really pretty fuchsia color. Love this. Do not fall in love with that swatch. Like, well, not the swatch itself, but the color. It's really pretty. I can't wait to try this on. But the fuchsia is nice. Not obviously with my eye makeup. But if you like fuchsia lipsticks, try to ignore the eye makeup. This is really, really, really pretty. Last shade. Very excited to tell you guys about. This is supposed to be a dupe of MAC Rebel, which you guys know I love. Especially, I wore it like, you know, all the time in fall. And you guys saw that. So this is the Ferguson Crest Cabernet, number 41. Very intimidating in the tube, just like Rebel is. But it's so pretty. It's a pretty plum. Check that out. So pretty. Let me pull out MAC Rebel. Let me zoom in for you guys, because you guys have to see this amazing dupeness, which I learned about from my friend Vanessa, who has a blog that's called Necessary Makeup, which was actually the first makeup blog I ever read, and she posted it on her Instagram that these are dupes. Thank you, Vanessa, by the way. This is an amazing dupe. And there are the swatches of the two. This is the Ferguson Crest Wet n Wild, and this is MAC Rebel. Really, really, really close. At least a 95% dupe right there. So that is great. And I'll put MAC Rebel on my bottom lip and keep the Wet n Wild on the top. Can you tell the difference? Because I can't. Wet n Wild on top, MAC Rebel on the bottom. And as you can see, my lips are stained. But I hope you guys enjoyed seeing this review haul, first impression. I'm just gonna call it a haul. Whatever it is. This collective haul with first impressions. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment and subscribe. And I will see you guys in a later video.